everyone, it is your favorite kind of punch, Mr. Falcon Punch 996, the underrated king, the recommendation master, and of course, YouTube's number one Doro Hidoro fanboy, back to bring you guys another new video. And today, I'll be reviewing a crossover between two legends, being Devilman versus Getter Robo.
As with most crossovers of this type, the story is rather simple. Kira and Mickey travel to Sao Tome Labs. However, following them is Siren and her demon army, who decide to team up with the Dinosaur Empire in order to destroy their common foes, and with that we have our crossover. Now, I was hyped as hell when I found out about this crossover. I mean, when you really think about it, you literally have a demonic superhero and giant robot teaming up to fight an army of demons who also teamed up with super advanced dinosaurs with mechs. That in itself is fucking awesome. However, there are some things here that kind of tarnish the overall experience. Now, this crossover was made by Go Nagai and features characters that aren't originally his, and usually when that happens, he sorta Nagaifies things. I mean, in a special chapter he did in Blackjack Alive, which was a special tribute for Osamu Tezuka's iconic character, he had Princess Knight, another Osamu Tezuka character, come up to Blackjack wanting him to give her a dick. Well, what he does to the Getter team here probably isn't as severe, it does seem kinda weird, as the Getter team here design-wise looks a lot like their 70s anime counterpart, which took its liberties from the original manga by Ken Ishikawa. However, personality-wise, they're like these hyperactive perverts trying to see Michiru naked as well as together hitting on Mickey, which is definitely not something you'd see the three normally do, and is the fastest way to piss off Akira, because even before the actual verses between Devilman and Getter Robo, it briefly turns into Akira versus the Getter team. Which is a shame, as part of my excitement with this crossover was seeing the Getter team most people know and love go super hot-blooded and kick ass with Devilman. And of course, you get some really Go Nagai scenes like Mickey and Michiru molesting each other, only to get eventually molested by a demon. Speaking of demons, while they do team up with the Dinosaur Empire, the whole thing in the end of the day really boils down to Siren taking the lead. Which, again, is a shame, because given this crossover, a proper team-up between the two would have made for a much more epic result. Despite the negatives, there are still plenty of cool things to find in this crossover, like the Getter Queen, a new mech piloted by Mickey Michiru in order to help the Getter and Devilman, though really it doesn't amount to much, since sadly, female robots just can't do shit unless it's Mazinger Angels. I'll also give this crossover props for actually having the verses in the name have some sort of value. As Devilman and Getter Robo do briefly fight, of course, it's nothing too epic when compared to one of the best things about this crossover. Devilman fusing with Getter Robo to kick some fucking ass as the Devil Getter, which looks amazing, and holy shit, that is just one badass way to wrap up this crossover. While definitely not lacking in awesome moments, this crossover is hindered quite a bit by some of its Nagaisms, since it does take away a lot from the Getter side of the crossover. That being said, this is an overall enjoyable time with awesome action, boobs, one kick-ass fusion, and a good amount of Go Nagai references a fan like me can appreciate.
And now it's time to wrap up this review. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and as always, I am MrFalconpunch996. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, check out the Facebook fan page, and if you haven't done any of that yet, you will be Falcon Punch in the face, so you better do it. See you guys next time. Peace.